A men's store restocking its shelf purchases 7 ties at $20 each.
7 ties for $20 each?
Yes.
Okay.
2 boxes of bow ties at $240 a box.
$240 a box?
Yes.
Okay.
And 1 box of string ties at 1.5 the price of 1 box of bow ties.
Okay, let's see. 1 box at 1.5 price?
How much did the restocking cost?
Okay, let me double check everything before we do the math, okay? First, I have 7 ties at $20 each.
Yeah.
You sure? And then you have 2 boxes at $240 per box.
Mm-hmm.
And then you have 1 box that's going to be 1.5 the price of the bow ties.
Mm-hmm.
So 1.5 times the 240, correct?
Yeah.
Okay. And we have to find out the total?
Yes.
Oh, all right. What do you think we're going to do?
You are going to multiply $20 times 70.
Okay, so let's do that. I'm going to do that in one color. So we've got $20 times 7 ties, correct?
Yes.
And 7 times 0?
Is 0.
And 2 times 7?
14.
All right, so we have $140 so far. Now we have 2 boxes at $240 a box?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, well, let's do that. We're going to take the 240, and what are we going to do with it with the 2?
You're going to multiply it.
Multiply it. So what's 240 times 2? Let's do it the long way. 2 times 0?
0.
2 times 4?
8.
And 2 times 2?
4.
Okay, so that there we are so far. And then you have 1 box that's at 1.5 the price of the bow ties, which is $240 per box, correct?
Yes.
Are you multiplying by decimals right now, or are you multiplying by fractions right now?
Right now, we are multiplying by fractions.
By fractions. Okay, so then I'm going to write this as 240 times 1.5. Can I do that? Or do I have to do something special with that fraction?
Wait.
Do you remember?
I think.
It's what I tell my kids. It's like going around the world. We're going to go from 2 to the whole number. And what are we going to do with those?
You are going to divide.
We're going to multiply. Okay? And then when we get that answer, we add what our numerator is, okay?
Okay.
Want to try? Here we go. 2 times 1.
2.
And then add one more.
3.
So I have 3, and I keep my denominator the same, okay? And now we're going to multiply that by 240. And I'm just going to write that so it looks like a fraction, so it makes it easier. All right?
Okay.
Here we go. 3 times 0?
0.
3 times 4?
12.
12. I'm going to put the 2, carry the 1. 3 times 2?
6.
Plus 1?
7.
Okay, and now let's multiply our denominators. 1 times 2?
2.
Oh, now I've got 720 all over the denominator of 2, right?
Yeah.
So what does that mean? What should I do?
That means you have to subtract.
Not subtract. If you have a fraction with a numerator that's bigger than the denominator, you want to divide the denominator into the numerator. Okay?
Okay.
So let's divide 2 into 720. 2 goes into 7 how many times?
0.
Oh, how many 2s are in 7?
3.
3. 3 times 2 is? 6, so we're going to take away 6. What's 7 minus 6?
7 minus 6 is 1.
1. Now I'm going to bring the 2 down. What's how many 2s are in 12?
6.
6. So 2 times 6 is 12. Now I got to bring this 0 down, and that's where the mistake happens. Everyone forgets about that 0 when they finish up. How many 2s are in 0? Nothing, right?
Yeah, there's nothing.
Okay, so now we have all our numbers because that's 360 when we're done. What do you think we need to find the total with the 140, the 480, and the 360? What do you think we have to do? We're finding total. If I asked you to go to your piggy bank and tell me how many pennies you had, what would you do?
Count.
You would count them. So counting is the same as adding. Right. So let's add them up. 0 goes plus 0 is 0. What's 4 plus 8?
12.
Now add 6 more to that.
18.
Okay. Carry the 1. I was waiting for the teen. And 1 plus 1?
2.
Plus 4?
8.
Ooh.
I mean, 6.
6 plus 3 more?
8.
6 plus 3. 6 plus 3?
9.
So the store spent $980 total to restock all of those ties.